I'm going to circumnavigate the globe in 80 days.
Send you off into this extraordinary adventure.
They're amazing.
I was like overwhelmed.
Let the adventure begin.
He's had a fairly timid life up to this point. He's not been an adventurer. They read this article in the newspaper about how it's now possible in 1872 to get around the world in 80 days because technology has advanced to such a degree. And in a moment of madness, really, Phileas Fogg decides that this is where his life changes.
He's not a real adventurer. He's even been in adventure against his will. He would love to stay quiet in a place and have no risk. Whereas Fogg is more about fancy and he knows a bit about, he doesn't know anything about the world apart from books. And that's the difference between them both.
Abby Ethics has written, at the beginning of the episode, of episode one, has written an article around the world in 80 days. She did a lot of research and found out, wrote an article about how it's now technically possible to travel around the globe in 80 days. And her father prints it, not under her name, which, you know, leads to a bit of a dispute, which of course makes her go, clearly I need to prove myself here. And traveling around the world with Fogg and Passepartout.
With this show, it could go many different ways. And really for us to feel that we've journeyed with him and that he's changed through that journey, and we really get a sense of who this character is underneath it all.
He's proper, you feel very safe. You feel like he is a master of his trade. You know, not an easy show to helm because there's so many disparate elements to bring into land. So much to sort of be ahead of. You know, each episode is a sort of, it's a kind of little film in itself. So we're very, very lucky to have Steve. And he's a very nice presence on set. Sebastian, our designer, has done an incredible job of realising all these various locations.
It's incredible. You really, even though you know it's just a set, you know, you really feel you feel you are in another century, and it's very, very beautiful. Even the smell, they worked on everything. They would animals poo so that you can have the real odor and everything.
Really, that was the challenge, because it was such a big production and such a changing production in terms of costumes. And
Kate Caron, our costume designer, is a genius, but what she's done is amazing, because she managed to create a look that is both very, very cool, but looks of the time. I mean, these boots were handmade for me. Yeah, I love all of the look. At the end of the day, it's about a story about missed opportunity, and it's like a call to live your life to the fullest.
And I think everybody can relate to that, and it's going to be really well. So we add the action, we add the story, and it's going to be very funny.
It's a very timeless story, isn't it? And hopefully what people will experience with this telling of the story is that sense of journey and adventure and the unknown. And I think there's lots of exciting stuff to keep you hooked.
Really think you can cross the entire globe in just 80 days?
Certainly, madame. Or die trying.
Why can't we get a train like normal people?